Hi, everyone. So there's a quote that says, laughter is the best medicine. I find truth in this quote because laughter is excellent for maintaining the health of the mind, body, and the soul. Laughter is contagious. It brings us happiness and good health rather than pain and distress. So today, I want to enlighten you about the benefits of laughter. And so the first one I'm going to be talking about is how laughter boosts your immune system, how it manages stress and pain, and thirdly, how it also gives you a burst of exercise. So my first point is how laughter boosts your immune system. According to a website called healthguide.org, laughter boosts your immune system by decreasing stress hormones, so it keeps those stress hormones under control so you do not feel as stressed out in the moment. And it also increases your immune cells, and it also increases infection-fighting antibodies, which provides resistance to contracting a disease. And adding more to that, according to another website called discovery.com or the Discovery Channel, laughter also improves your circulation of blood flow in your body, and it also increases your blood flow in your body, and it also increases your amount of oxygen intake. So with that, it releases negative emotions, thus keeping you healthy and boosting your immunological responses. So while laughter does that to your immune system, it comes to my second point is that laughter also helps manage stress and pain. So according to healthguide.org, it's just laughter triggers a release of endorphins. And endorphins are the body's natural best feel-good chemicals. So endorphins make people happy. And along with this, it provides you with a sense of well-being and it temporarily relieves the pain. So you think about it, laughter is one of the best remedies to relieving pain because it's effective, it's for free, and you do not need a prescription for laughter. So, and also, what laughter does is that laughter can also reduce fear and anger, and it can help you handle a painful situation. So, according to discovery.com, laughter proves to be one of the best distractions of maintaining and kind of managing a painful situation. So it helps, laughter helps beat stress, anger, sadness, anxiety, and all of those factors. So as it does that to your immune system, it helps manage your stress and pain. It comes to my third point that laughter also helps you provide a burst of exercise. So according to that same website, discovery.com, laughing 100 times is equivalent to 10 minutes on a rowing machine or 15 minutes on a stationary bicycle. So when you think about it, laughter is one of the best exercises because it clears your respiratory system, it helps your amount of oxygen intake, and it just provides one of the best exercises for your body. And you don't really need to break a sweat while laughing. So now I'm going to show you guys a quick video from the movie called Patch Adams. How many have seen Patch Adams? Okay, a few of you. So, people who have not seen it, a quick overview about the clip I'm going to show you guys. Patch Adams, the main character, his name is Patch Adams, and he's played by Robin Williams, and he's a medical student aspiring to become a doctor because he feels like he has a connection to people. So, in this clip I'm going to show you guys, Patch Adams enters a children's ward, and he sees these sad children laying on their hospital beds, and an idea comes to his mind of how he can make these children happy, even for the moment being. So I hope you guys enjoy this clip.
It's fine.
the best medicine because it is good. It is excellent and for maintaining health, maintaining the health for the mind, for your mind, body, and the soul. So today I went over how laughter boosts your immune system, how it manages stress and pain, and thirdly how it also gives you a burst of exercise. So overall, a good laugh can enlighten our lives and it can bring peace to our minds because it is the best natural remedy.
Oh, great. Christine, you did a very nice job on a lot of stuff. I like the quote and the opinion at the beginning of the speech. You've got a dramatic statement of your point of view. You've got an excellent summary of what your goal is and an excellent preview. There's one thing that's sticking out, because I'm going to be saying the word excellent and really good. A lot of times you did a nice job, so pay attention to those things when I say them too, but everybody always pays attention to the negative stuff that I pick out. I know that they focus on. Your transitions are just so awkward and obvious that it's, when you get to that first point, you basically say, so let's go to my first point. And I mean, you've indicated that, but it's got to be a little bit smoother than that. It's got to be a little bit more creative. It just, the second and the third ones were better, but I mean, I felt that and I thought, oh my gosh, it's, you know, it's like you're going through the motions. Did I give you the smog analogy? Did you guys learn to drive? When you learned to drive, did they teach you the smog analogy?
Never.
When you're supposed to signal, check your mirror, look over your shoulder, and go when it's safe. Smog. Signal, mirror, over shoulder, go when safe. All right? You never heard that? All right, so that's the idea. But it's very technical, but that's one of the ways that people learn things. They go through the steps. I have to do X, I have to do Y, I have to do Z, that kind of thing. That's kind of the way it felt like you were doing it. It's like, I know that I have to do a signpost on my first point, I have to finish my transition, and I'm doing this, and it's like I can see you going through the process and hear you going through the process of doing that while you're doing it. You want to get to the point where that's something that's a little bit more natural. Like I said, I thought you did better on the other things. Now, having said that, everything else I thought was really solid. You got a lot of content here. You've got good explanations. You talk to us really effectively. You're looking at us most of the time. Your voice takes command and has got good energy in it. Even though it's sometimes is a little bit quiet, it always sounds like you are in charge. You know where you're going and that everybody should be paying attention to you. I like that a lot. Maybe a little more introduction of the video than was necessary. I think you got. I think you say, you know, Patch Adams is a doctor who's, you know, trying to figure out how to help kids in the children's ward. You know, much more than that, I think is probably unnecessary. But like I said, those are minor quibbles. I thought, from the presentation point of view, you did a very nice job. All right, thank you.